This is going to be the upper end of my connecting rod. This will go on the connecting rod, and this will be the rod cap. This is drilled 1/4 inch to run on a piece of 1/4 inch cold roll steel. I drilled those with a brad point bit. This will go on to a 5/16 wood dowel. I drilled a weep hole, so when I put glue in here and I put those dowels in while I'm turning them, that excess glue will come out this hole. Because I drilled this with a 1/4 inch brad point bit that's fairly snug on that piece of cold roll steel, I'm going to burnish these. That polishes the inside of that bore and loosens it up a little bit so it won't run quite so tight on that piece of 1/4 inch cold roll steel. I find it a lot easier to make this all in one piece. You can drill all the holes, keep everything square, cut these off, sand them to dimension, round over all the corners and edges. The throw on this crankshaft is 2 inches, one up, one down. I'll take my connecting rod here, and this one will just slide on over the end. And I get that at top dead center. I make a mark on the end of this wood dowel, and that shouldn't quite collapse the bellows. And I go to bottom dead center, and that shouldn't quite be full extension on the bellows. You take that mark, cut that wood dowel to that length, and then try it again. So with the dowel, the top dead center, or its highest point of travel, I can check the length of that dowel, and that won't quite collapse that bellows. And I go the other way. Make sure the dowel is at full extension downwards or at bottom dead center. And that hasn't quite extended that bellows all the way. And that's going to be my 2 inches of travel. I cut this dowel to the correct length and sanded the end, then drilled a hole in the center of it for this small sheet metal screw. There's a good chance that dowel is going to want to split when I run that in there. So I took a 3/4 inch length, a 3/4 inch wood dowel. This looks like beech. And again, this is from that World War II flag set. I know the grain direction of the dowel runs this way. When I glue this on here, I want my wood grain to be at right angles to that. And that should be good support for the end of that dowel. An alternate way of doing this is to drill the hole for a screw and then wrap the end of that dowel very tightly with string or with wire, and then I coat it with epoxy. And that's another way to keep that from splitting. You'll probably find it necessary to grind this off to clear that 3/8 inch rod for the clutch mechanism. And I went ahead and I ground this one off a little bit just for the heck of it. I like to put timing marks on things like this. I put one dot on each side of this joint, and I put two dots on either side of the other one. So if I have both of them taken apart, I don't get the pieces mixed up, and I know which way this goes on for the screws to line up. On the end of this metal strap on the bottom of the bellows, there's a rubber grommet. I'm going to take that screw with a washer. I'm going to run that carefully through that grommet. I don't want to tear it up. And then that will go into the end of that wooden dowel. I'm going to put a washer on the other side of that grommet as well. And I don't tighten this real tight. I just make it just, like again, I use the term snug. That allows some freedom of movement in that screw. And that's all that's needed for the end of that connecting rod. I like to form these threads a couple of times with the drill so I know they'll go together easy. And then when I assemble this, make sure you time your screw so you don't strip these threads. I'm using a segmented crankshaft. This has an awful lot of advantage doing it this way, because if you weld a crankshaft, you can have so much distortion. And a friend of mine, Jay Cochran, made these, and that makes life a little easier. You determine how long this piece of rod needs to be. This is 5/16, as is this. This part of the crankshaft is 1/4 inch, and this is a 1-inch throw. Now, we do not want this to be able to go back and forth, so there's 2 5/16 locking collars. We're running in a top hat bushing here and on this end, and this is just a straight bushing, and I don't want that to be able to go back and forth very much. And that's the job of the locking collars. They limit the travel of this piece of rod back and forth. You want the 5/16 to be flush here and here so that they don't interfere with the top end of the connecting rod, and that's true for this end right here as well. If you make your friction collar out of rolled up paper and sandpaper like they show in the plans, or if you take an aluminum wheel and knurl it, I find this is very solid. That's another one of Jay's gadgets that makes life a little easier. You want this Hoover belt to run right in the center of that. When I installed this screw, I put a washer on each side of the grommet to support it. Run that up inside this dowel. I just want to barely compress that rubber grommet. I don't want to tighten it too tight. That allows that to flex at that point. When you start playing with this, you want to make sure at the top of your bench or your table saw is clean so that you don't suck anything up inside those bellows. There's quite a bit of air velocity going in and out of those holes.